I don't want any baloney, magic tricks, or psychological mumbo jumbo.
In accordance with our instructions, we continued toward the planet which its inhabitants called the Earth, in order to study their mode of life. The intelligent creatures on this planet call themselves human beings, and they exist in an amazing variety of conditions. Some live in heat-laden jungles, wearing very little clothing on their bodies. Some live in huts made from branches and leaves which grow abundantly nearby. And although the streets of this country are lined with four-wheeled vehicles, all looking very much alike, the individual will ignore every vehicle but one, which he calls his own. We found others who cover their bodies with great gaudiness, even though the heat may be just as great. Some shovel food into their mouths with tiny silver utensils. These cultures are vastly different from each other. And yet, in spite of these great differences, we found that all these human beings share many things in common. Many things in common. Whether persons belong to a primitive tribe or to a complex civilization, they know fairly well what life has in store for them. In addition, they all have gestures, which sometimes make mere vocal language seem quite inadequate as a means of communication. This mode of life is called by the Earth's social scientists the culture of the group. These cultures are vastly different from each other. Different from each other. And yet, in spite of these great differences, we found that all these human beings share many things in common. Many things in common. Human beings.
We're gonna need some more coffee.